Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about how to model a thermal management system of a battery electric vehicle. Here this example models the thermal management system of a battery electric vehicle. Here the system consists of two coolant loops, one refrigeration loop and one cabin HVAC loop. Based on that, the system is constructed. Then the thermal loader, batteries, powertrains and cabins. Here the two coolant loops can be joined together in serial mode or kept separate in parallel mode using the four-way valve system. Here this is a scenario subsystem and another one is a control subsystem. This scenario subsystem setups the environment conditions and inputs to the systems for the selected scenarios, and also this the battery current, current demand and the powertrain heat load are a function of vehicle speed based on the tabulated data. Here is the environmental block contains pressure, temperature and relative humidity and CO2 in the form of the tabulated data. Here also this cabin HVAC system, this is our power demand, this is our vehicle system subsystem, vehicle subsystem speed. Subsystem is a drive cycle. It shows the drive cycle. This is one. This is by using signal builder, we can model this vehicle speed, kilometer per hour. Here, this is the power demand. This power demand subsystem we are created with this IQ, which is a battery and inverter, motor, and charger current. These are the blocks are there, inverter heat versus current block, and motor heat versus current, and charger heat versus current, and DC to DC converter heat versus current. These are all the things we are going to analyze. Then next, this is a control subsystem. This control subsystem consists of all the controllers for the pumps, compressor, fan, blower, and valves in the thermal management system. Here you can see this is a fan controller, coolant loop controller, compressor controller, cabin air controller. For example, if fan controller as this is a condenser requirement and inverter requirement and motor requirement, all are working together with this control subsystem toolbox. Here each and every systems, these are scopes are used to find out the signals, output signals. This is a measurement block is there. First we start with this parallel series mode valve in the subsystem. In this system, we can see is a parallel mode flow path is port A, port A to port D and port C to port B. If it is the system, the value subsystem is set in serial mode flow path A to B and C to D. Sir, what is A to B, what is A to D and what is C to B here? The four-way values in the subsystem controls whether the coolant loop operates in parallel or serial mode. Okay. Then when ports A and D, these are ports A and D, A, B, C, D ports are there. When ports A and D are connected and ports C and B are connected, it is in parallel mode. Okay. Whereas when ports A and B connected and port C and D connected, it is in serial mode. Okay. Here there are two modes are mode of operation is there in this parallel series mode valve. Then you can see the pump subsystem, motor pump subsystem. In this motor pump subsystem, the pumps drives the coolant loops that cools the chargers, motor and this inverter. Next one, there is a charger subsystem. In this charger subsystem is having the charger, coolant and jacket. This subsystem models a coolant jacket around the charger, which is represented by a heat flow rate source and a thermal mass here. Next one is a motor subsystem. This motor subsystem, this subsystem models a coolant jacket around the motor, which is represented by a heat flow rate source and a thermal mass. Similarly, each and every subsystem, that is the inverter subsystem, it shows the same value. This is a another one is a cabin subsystem, this is your blower subsystem, this blower subsystem is constructed with this environment air, recirculation flap and another blower, and moisture air properties are involved here. Then this is a chiller expansion valve, and this is a evaporator expansion valve, and this is a radiator bypass valve, where there are four value subsystem, four values in the subsystem is utilized here to construct this electric vehicle thermal management system. Here what are the basic operation is that three modes are given here, electric vehicle thermal management. First one is drive cycle mode, and second one is cool down mode, and third one is cold weather mode. Here in cold weather, for example, if you choose, you can see the controls scenario. Previously it shows a cold weather. If you change drive cycle, means automatically it says, you can see here drive cycle and cool down. You can select either three scenarios are there by using these three modes of scenario setups. For example, drive cycle mode is, if you choose drive cycle mode is 30 degree weather condition, 30 degree Celsius weather condition. If you choose cool down scenario, means cool down configuration, means 40 degree Celsius weather condition. And if you choose cold weather scenario, means minus 10 degree, which requires a battery heater and also PTC, PTC heater to warm up the batteries and cabinet. Here what is meant by PTC heater means nowadays modern electric vehicles having this positive temperature coefficient heater, PTC heater. It's more useful to protect the battery from the high temperature, so that in modern electric vehicle the PTC heater are involved here. Then similarly, the radiator subsystem having this by using this radiator block, and this is a condenser block, condenser subsystem by using this condenser refrigeration properties. Here in refrigeration loops, it consists of one compressor and one condenser and one liquid receiver, and also the expansion valves, a chiller and an evaporator. Here by in this block, the chiller used to cool the coolant in hot weather condition when the radiator alone is insufficient. And the evaporator block, this evaporator is used to cool the vehicle cabin when the air condition is turned on. Similarly, we have one HVAC loops are there. In this HVAC loop, it can consist of one blower and one evaporator, one PTC heater with the vehicle cabin here. The PTC heater, it provides heating in cold weather condition. The evaporator provides pressure and temperature sensor placed here. There is a PTC air volume, it's a PTC heater. The PTC heater provides heating in cold weather. The evaporator provides air conditioning in hot water. And the blower is controlled to the main control to maintain the specified cabin temperature set point. Now we can run this simulation. In this Simulink, we can use three modes of operation, and also you can open this model workspace, you can explore the parameters. Also you can modify, just click here, these are the code to define parameters for the this Simulink example file. Here it shows the initial conditions and vehicle cabin, liquid cooling system, refrigeration system, compressor map table, and radiator, condenser, and also evaporator, chiller, batteries. Each and every subsystem you can modify the parameters. Now also we can explore the simulation result using SSC Explorer. In all my videos, by using this Simulink result explorer, that is SSC Explorer is nothing but result explorer. We can analyze each and every subsystem of this model, subsystem of your model. If you click here, it means learn more about this model with this Matlab website. Okay, now we can see what is our help file. Here, this is the electric vehicle thermal management example available in MathWorks website, that is a MATLAB website. In this documentation, you can see all the type of block descriptions, scenario subsystems, and coolants, what is the control subsystems. Here, a parallel serial mode. Kindly go through this documentation available in MathWorks. Now, let us see the simulation. When you click and run, here is the stop time is 3600 seconds. So, just after run this one, you are getting this type of output. This is scenario is cold weather scenario. In this cold weather scenarios, vehicle speed and what is the cabin temperature. Here the legend shows, the yellow line shows the cabin temperature and the blue line shows the environment temperature, and orange line shows the set point. This is our set point, that is a 21 degree Celsius. Here cabin temperature, here at particular condition, if you temperature reaches with this threshold level, the constant temperature is maintained by our thermal management system. Similarly, here this is a vehicle speed also not affecting. Here heat flow rates, here motor, batteries, condenser, chiller, and evaporator, radiator, heat flow rates are described here. And also component temperature, there is a pump and compressor commands, and also value commands are shown here. Then you can see by using this measurement scope. Then also the Simulink result explorer block. By using this block, each and every subsystem you can see the output. Say T and B, there is a coolant jacket one section at port A, at port B, at port H. It's a thermal model, it's a voltage sensor output. Based on that, each and every model, every subsystem you can see the output. It's at the motor pumps subsystem, it is a PTC heater subsystem. Here, what is the absolute reference value, and you can measure the controlled heat flow rate. Based on that things, you can measure the pressure as a temperature sensor output. Here, these are by using this model, you can analyze by using this SimScape result interactive, SimScape result explorer application app here. Yeah, the important one is by using this thermal management system, this model is a combination of thermoelectric cooling, forced air cooling, and also liquid cooling. Okay, so that by using this electric vehicle thermal management example, you can configure the three more scenarios. One is drive cycle based, another one is cool down based, and the final one is cold weather based. Based on that, you can modify and analyze the system, modeling of this thermal management system of a battery electric vehicle example. If you are new subscriber to watch my channel, means kindly subscribe my channel, please support us. Thanks for watching. Thank you. In my YouTube channel description section, the file is available, so that you can easily download this file. Also, you can access this file, and after got permission, you can modify these parameters. For example, open the models by workspace to explore the parameters, and also you can see the simulation result using SSC Explorer, and also you can learn more example with this MathWorks website. Thanks for watching. Thank you.